Now, let's cut to the chase. Here's the good news.
Yeah.
Your social security, your next social security increase, may be the largest in 40 years.
Why do I get stuck with the bad news?
Sorry.
The bad news, it may not be nearly enough. Oh. Well, let's Szarka from Szarka Financial is here to kind of help us sort it all out. So let's talk about this. Why is there an increase in social security?
Well, the good news, again, is that it's going to go up, because we've seen over the last, I'd say over the last 10 years, a very, very nominal increase in social security for retirees. And we've actually had 2 years where there's no increases. Mm-hmm. So it's actually a welcome relief that it's going to be higher. But the bad news is that, you know, the reason it's going up is because the cost of living has gone up so much.
Yeah.
Inflation. I mean, just last May, gasoline was $1.74. Today, I just put some in it. It was, what, 3.15 or something like that.
And it's been higher. Yeah,
yeah, that's 80% increase. And the bad news, again, is that it's also, we haven't even factored in there with heating costs, because propane and natural gas is also up about 80% from a little bit over a year ago. So, you know, wait till the winter months come. So, you know, the good news is that you are going to see an increase in your Social Security. But the bad news is it's because of the fact that all of our expenses are going up pretty dramatically.
Yikes. Yeah,
let's get specifics if we can. You know, say someone's 67 now, because you can't collect Social Security till 65, 67?
No, 62 you can start.
62.
Full retirement age is 67.
So 67, your full benefit is $2,000 a month a lot of times?
Yeah.
What's the increase like for those folks who can cash in?
Well, they haven't announced it yet. It's probably going to be in that 3%, 3 to 4% range, somewhere around in there. But here's the other issue: is for retirees, your cost of living is different than, let's say, for someone that's got a younger kids. For an older person, their cost of living is tied more to things like medical expenses,
mm-hmm.
food.
Right.
I mean, you're not spending things on kids. You're not spending, you know, you're not buying a house every year, things like that. So for retirees, I know ARP did a study 2-3 years ago. Inflation for a retiree typically runs about 2% higher than for the average person.
Wow.
Just because of how they're spending their money. They're spending it on necessities. And so cost of living kind of jimmy rigs the numbers a little bit,
sure,
to make it look like it's a little bit lower, because that's what all Social Security increases are based on, mm-hmm. federal pay and those kinds of things. So if they can make inflation look a little bit lower than it really is, then they save, the government saves a lot of money. So the way that retirees spend money, I think, are going to be hurt even more because of the fact that their cost of living has gone up, you know, probably 6 or 7%. I mean,
at not the rate they're getting back.
Correct.
3%.
And do they get taxed on that?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, Social Security.
Depending on your income. So Social Security under a certain limit is tax free.
Mm-hmm.
If you, it can be either half of it can be taxed or 85%, depending on what your income is. So for someone who's living just on Social Security, it's tax free. For someone that's got a pension and, you know, they've got some investments, you know, 85% of that Social Security is taxed.
Help us, Les. You're here,
yeah,
to help us. That's a 3% raise, but if you're talking about a 6% increase in daily spending,
that
you're down 3.5%.
Right.
How do we fill the gap?
And so here's the problem is, you know, when inflation runs really low and you're getting, you know, let's say, you know, 0.5% or whatever on the bank account, you're only about 1.5% behind. If your cost of living is 6% and you're still only getting 0.5%, you know, on your investment, that means you're 5.5% behind.
So for sure,
I think it's going to force a lot of retirees to look for alternatives and try to get a higher rate of return on their investments, where maybe they're not too comfortable doing that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this isn't like 2007 where you could get a CD and get, you know, 5 or 6%.
You can't, and then you take a risk and then you can lose some of that,
correct,
money. So you don't want to be worse off.
Right. And I'm hearing a lot of stories. I'm talking to a lot of folks, you know, where they've been talked into an investment and they really don't fully understand the risks involved. So you got to go into those investments, you know, with eyes wide open. Yes, you're going to get paid more, but then you're also going to have to be willing to put up with a lot more fluctuation. So, you know, again, I don't want to leave viewers with a negative tone, because, I mean, we are going to see a larger increase in Social Security, but I think it's also going to be incumbent on retirees to be a little bit more creative,
right,
in terms of how they're going to manage the difference between the, you know, what inflation is and what their cost of increase is.
See, kids, this is why you got to get good grades in school, because you're going to have to pay for mom and dad a little bit later in life.
Yeah, and grandkids, you might get as many presents from grandparents.
Hello.
Now, right?
Good stuff. See, you got to let us know about these pitfalls that are coming,
yeah,
and help us get there and fill those gaps along the way. So if you have any financial questions or need more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can head to our website, foxaid.com, click on Seen on TV. Always a pleasure, Les. Thanks
for being
here.
Great to see you.
Nice to be back in the studio.
Yay, great to have you here.
Really is.
Great to have you here. Thank you.